Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. Today in this tutorial we are discussing about the lambda functions and map functions. First we'll begin with the lambda functions. Lambda functions are nothing but these are the functions which are defined without a name. That's why it is also called as anonymous functions. Generally, in Python, we'll define a function using def keyword, right? For example, we'll define function like this, def followed by function name, if my function name is display, okay? Next, we'll mention parameter list. Next, this will be the function body, right? This is the general syntax of functions in Python. But this lambda functions doesn't contain any def keyword. So the syntax of lambda function is, these functions are defined using the keyword lambda. So first lambda, next followed by argument list. Okay, so we need to mention the arguments. It can contain one or more than one arguments. Next, expression. As I said, lambda function can contain one or more than one arguments, but it should contain only one expression. Okay, this is the keyword, and this lambda function returns function object, and to store that function object we will use variables. Okay, so here is the example. Here we can see, so this is the normal functions in Python. Here we can see it is started with the def keyword. And here we can see the function name, parameters, and function body. And this is the lambda function. Here we can see this is the keyword lambda, and these are the arguments. Here in the example, there are two arguments, x and y, and this is the expression. Okay, so this is about the syntax of lambda. So next, if you ask, when we will use this lambda functions or anonymous functions, this function can be used when we need a function for short period of time. Next, it can be used as the arguments in the higher order functions. Higher order functions are nothing but the functions which will use another function as arguments. So in that case, we can use lambda function as the arguments in the higher order function. Next, we can see the advantage of the lambda function when it is used with the some built-in functions like map, reduce, filter. So next we'll discuss about the map function and how this lambda function is used in that map function. In the next tutorial, we'll discuss about the filter and reduce function. Okay, so next is the map function. This is the built-in function. And this function is used to apply a function to all the element of a sequence. Okay, so this is a little bit confusing, right? So we'll take example. Before that, we'll see the syntax of map function. So the syntax of map function is, first we need to mention map. Okay, next we need to mention the function. Next here, sequence. So we all know list, tuple, strings, these are called as sequence, right? So here we can use list or tuples or strings. Here this is the function. So if you want to apply some function on the each element of the sequence, that is list, tuple, or strings, then you can use this map function. Okay, for example, if you want to find out the square of each element of a list, then you can use this map function. So I'll show you the example now. So first here I'll show you how to use map function without using lambda function. Next we'll see how to use lambda function in map function. Okay, here we want to find out square of each element of a list. So first I need to take one list. Okay, so I'll take my list as A, and I'll take element as 1 2 3 4. Okay, next in the output, I want 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, that is 1, 4, 9, 16. So for that, first we need to define a function. So here I'll take def, and I'll take my function name as square. and I'll take one parameter, and here in the function body I'll write return x to x, because we want to find out the square of that number, right? So this is the function. Next, now I'll use map function. Okay, map. Here I need to mention the function first, right? That is function name. Here my function name is square, so square. Okay, next I need to mention the sequence, that is on which sequence you are applying this function. I want to apply this on the list A, so I'll mention A. Here we can see an iterator. Here in Python 3, here we can say I'm using Python 3.5.1. Here in Python 3, this map will returns the iterator. But in Python 2, map will returns the list. So in Python 3, if you want to get the output as list, then you should use list of, then you can write map. Here we can write function name as square and list name as A, and enter. Here we can see the output 14916. Here if you want output in the tuple, then here you need to mention tuple. Okay, if you are using Python 2, then no need to mention this list or tuple. Directly you can write this function, because in Python 2 it will returns list. Okay, so next. Okay, so here we use the map function without using the lambda function. If you want to use lambda function, then you can write like this. So map. Okay, here only I'll define the lambda function. So lambda, and here I'll take my argument, one argument, that is x. Next I'll write expression as x multiply x. Okay, so this is my function. Next I'll write a, this is list. So here instead of this function I'm using lambda function. We'll get the same output because we are find out in the square of each element of the list A. Okay, so here I'll convert this output to list, because I want to see the output in the list form. So this is map function using lambda function. Here next we can use more than one list or tuple in the map function. Suppose if you want to add two list, then you can use this map function for that. So here we can see we already have one list called A. Next I'll create another list called B. I'll write 1, 1, 1, 1. So while adding two list, you should remember both the list should have same length, that is nothing but both list contain same number of elements. And the next thing is we can't add string and integer value, right? So both list should contains numbers. It can be integer or it can be floating point value, but it should contain numbers, or both list should contain strings. So be careful about that. So now what I'll do is I'll take map. And I need to mention the function, right? So I'll mention lambda. Here we want to add two numbers, so I need two parameter, x comma y, and the expression will be x plus y. We want to add two list. Next here I'll mention my list as a comma b. Okay, so now we want to convert this iterator output to list or tuple. So here I'll convert my output to tuple. Okay, so I'll need to mention tuple there. So enter. Here we can see 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we can see 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. Okay, this is the output. We can add list and tuple also. In the same way, we'll get the output. So if you are using Python 2, then I said map function will returns the list. So we'll check that. Okay, so here we can say I am using Python 2.7. so I'll take one list called A, and here I'll take my element as 2, 3, 4. Okay, so next I'll use map. I'll take lambda. Here I'll find out the square of each number. Okay, and a. So here list, we can directly see the output. Here we can see this map function will returns the list in Python 2. Okay, so this is about the map function as well as lambda functions and how to use lambda function with the map functions. So that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you next class. Till then, take care.